All right, guys, welcome back to Exit 45 Restorations, and we're going to get back on the Thunderbird because we got to get the interior prepped. We got to get the rust coating paint down. We need to get the hush mat in, electrical run. All those things need to be taken care of before we can start to build up the firewall and put all those components in. So let's get it done and get going. Let's go. All right, so before we go to do anything inside the interior here, as far as starting to put some stuff back up in the dash or wiring harness or any of those things, I need to get a rust encapsulator down here and coat this floor. And I've got the Eastwood. You can see that right there. So that's what I'm going to use. So let's go ahead and get this stuff on. I've never used any of this kind of stuff before, so it looks pretty straightforward. Brush it on. So, anyway. Alright. I mean, it applies good. I don't have any issues with that. It seems to coat well. Spreads good. I don't, you know, the real question is, does it work? You know, I mean, for the purpose that you're putting it on, I mean, I'm putting it on as a coating just to kind of give this thing one kind of even coat of something. And really, I only got a few areas of rust. So I'm not really putting this on here for rust mostly. It's a preventative measure mostly for me. All right, so far it's going pretty good. It's going down good. Cover's really good. All right, we'll just get you a quick look in here. It's still wet. It'll dry to a more dull finish. But it coated well. Easy enough. Seems to float itself out. It doesn't seem to retain the brush marks, which doesn't really matter. But, yeah, I mean, if this stuff does its job, like they say, it'll protect you from any future rust. And it's got a good coating on it now, so. All right, here we go. Second half. All right, guys, I think we got it. I mean, it's all black, so I guess I got it. All right, let's bring around the other side. We'll just do a quick look-see. And then we'll, as soon as this dries up. All right. She's starting to take shape. All right, well, hopefully this stuff works as good as they say it does. I mean, I hardly have any rust, so I don't know that it matters a whole lot. I'm just looking for future protection, something to coat it and protect it for future rust. So, all right. What you want, bud? What you want, Pep? Yep, you want just wants to complain. All right, complaint department's closed. All right, guys, I'm going to let this dry up. So one of the other things we're going to do while we're prepping the interior is we're going to start to lay in the harnesses again. And so really what we're trying to do here is we're trying to go through and look for, see how that's just garbage. It's dry rotted and fallen off. So we're going to go through and identify all those areas. You can see right here, my dad's getting rid of some of this old sheathing. We've got a cut wire in our bundle. There's a bare wire right here. So we're going to go through and identify there's a nick in that wire. We're going to identify all these things and fix all this and get something on there to protect the wires so that we know when we go in together with this, we have a good harness. All right, just give you guys an update on the wiring harness. So we've got the engine bay cleaned up, made all of our patches and repairs, and I just got it setting in here for now just to keep it out of the way. But check what we got next. Look how big that is. My dad's not happy. Okay, guys, so we got to go through this entire interior harness and do the exact same thing. Clean it, look for any issues, and we'll start right there. And we'll work our way down. It's like playing Candyland. Do, 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 do. Roll the dice, whatever, spin the wheel, whatever you do. And you just work your way. When you get to the end, you win. All right, guys, we're going to get at that. And again, we'll bring you in when it's done. All right, just bringing you up to date on what we got going on here with the brake pedal assemblies and basically, you know, what we're doing on the firewall area. So we got this here, emergency brake pedal. We got it sandblasted. I'm going to go ahead and drill that off so we can replace it. I got a new one here. I got a new rubber pedal as well as the brake pedal. I got that new. This piece here we've already got sandblasted, painted, and ready to go. So we're moving along on all this. And then out here, I've got the remainder of the pieces sandblasted and ready for paint. So we're moving along. My dad will be here in a few hours, and he will start working on this some more. So, yep, we're getting there. All right, let's get this off. Okay, then we got the rivet off. The new one comes with some bolts and you just bolt it on. So just gotta get the rivets out. We'll get that off of there and we'll put the new one on. That was easy. All right. Yeah, I need to drill this one off too. So it comes with it comes with three of them, so we're good. Let's get this one off. There we go. Okay, we got it. All right, so the next thing for this will be I'm going to get it painted, get it all protected. All right, let me get this. Let me get this painted. Just a bull in a china shop. Okay, so looks like we got this one all put together. Vacuum's hooked back up, and we're going to go ahead and give it a test. See if she pulls it. There we go. And then there'll be a spring from here to here. So when he releases it, it would just pull that back. And then it goes all the way, and then that would release the pedal to come up. But we've got to have that spring on there. And our spring is broke. So I got to find a spring for it. All right, so there's the emergency brake cable, or not cable, but pedal. We got the new pad on it. So looks like we're in pretty good shape there. Now we got to get this put together, the main brake pedal. All right, I'll let him get to that. Well, there you go. My dad got the brake pedal assembly all wrapped up. Looks good. We got our new pad on there. And of course you saw this earlier, so we got that done. Let me show you what else we got. My brother came over with, and he got this all cleaned up, and that's ready for me to put back in. So I got them working ahead of things so that the firewall, you know, is starting to get ready to go. Well, I'm back out and after it, but before I get to the shop, I just have a little bit of clearing and cleanup to do before, you know, all the stuff reclaims in my yard. And, you know, you guys know I like to burn, so. All right, well, I guess I've done enough burning over here, so let's head over to the shop and see if we can't get ourselves into some trouble over there. Well, I got this side over here ready. I know it doesn't look very clean, but I've scrubbed it. It's just, I guess, stained. Either way, it's cleaned up. We're gonna put this, I guess it's called kill mat. So I hope nobody dies in the installation process, because I'm the only one doing it.
I need you to move. You're in my way. Yes. Come on, now you're gonna make this not sticky.
You see what I gotta put up with? Can't find good help. I'm gonna press on and I'll give you some updates here and there. Okay, so you can see I got most of this side done. I just got want to get some on the tunnel. You can see I got the one up there. You know, this thing came apart. They had a heavy like tar board or tar something on there. So we're just going back on there with something else to help keep some of the noise down. Well, looky what I got done, guys. There you go. So now I know you don't need to do the whole thing. You just need it placed every so much every square foot. as much of a pain in the butt this stuff is, I'll probably do that next time. But either way, it's in. All right, that is one thing checked off the list on prepping this interior to start installing everything. So the next thing, right there, I got my insulation pad that goes on the firewall. That is going to go up next. Hey, guys. So I guess we got all the hush mat in. Looks pretty good. So we're gonna work on that. So the insulation gets put up here on the firewall. So the fun part's going to be figuring out which holes are for these. There's all kinds of holes. So I guess I'll just push them through and we'll figure it out. I mean, I'll figure it out. Hey, I'll figure it out. Give me a break. I'm getting it. Look, see? I'm going to just put these in the hole and then I'll have to figure out. I'll put it up on the to the firewall and I'll start matching up the holes, I guess. That's the only thing I know to do. Let's get this thing up. Well, I got the two pins down, pushed in most of the way over here. They're really hard to push in. I got one right here ready to go in, and then I've got, looks like, three more that I gotta figure out where they go and get the rest of this in. All right, let me get these other three in. Here we go. I got it all in. I did have to ream out a couple of the holes. They just must have been fairly thick with the paint. I couldn't get the pin to go through. So anyway, that's all in. So now I'd like to bring the electrical harness back in here and start kind of just getting it generally routed where it's going to go and start figuring that out. All right, guys. Do you remember where all this went? Oh my gosh, this is not going to be fun. We'll get it, but it's not going to be fun. All right, so I'm gonna just see if I can't get it in a general location that each area is supposed to be at, and we'll just tighten it little by little as we figure out the routing. All right, here we go. Well, there you have it. I have the wire harness section that goes over here on the driver's side because I labeled it. I labeled that part there. Let me get up there. They go the center area, so I know that goes up underneath the dash in the center. That one's a little bit obvious because of the circuit breaker panel. And then I labeled this one here with the tag there. You can see it for the center console area. I've labeled each one of these runs here, driver side and passenger side, for the window operation and all that. And then the courtesy lights, you got the courtesy lights that go back here. And then you can see this run here that runs into the trunk, and that's going to feed to your lights, backup lights, all that, fuel sending unit, those types of things. So we're pretty good. I got the this area here's already, come sticking out for the door. I'll do the same on the other side. I've got new door light switches. These are not working. So I can go ahead and get that installed here on either side. So I can just go to the areas that I know where they go, and I can start working on them and just slowly work my way around. And if I don't know where it goes, that's okay, because as I start to put some of the things back in here, then it'll all start to work itself out. So it is just freaking cool. Let me just say that, putting stuff back in here, getting the harness back in, I'm digging this. Okay, so let me get you guys in here and give you an update on where I'm at with the routing. So just looking over this book here, very helpful. So what I've got here, so figuring out where these plastic routing things go, I figured this one here now, I got this one right. I know this one goes here, where it'll go right above the brake pedal assembly. And then you keep coming back this way, there's a smaller one that goes here. There should be, if I'm not mistaken, something that pops out of here. I don't know, otherwise it wouldn't be a notch there. These all have worked out where they break out at these openings, so I gotta figure that out. This one here goes on this side, but I gotta figure out this part of the harness here. So I haven't figured that out yet. Anyways, this will right here will secure right up there. All this will route along this top side. Some will route down here, some will route above the brake, like that. And then you got all your final pieces that are coming over here. So we'll just keep bringing you in as I get this tightened up more and more. I can't tighten up all this until I get the brake pedal assembly in. So that's gonna have to happen up here. And then I gotta figure that side out. Where does that route? How high up? I think it routes above the opening there for the heater AC. I think it routes right up above there and then drops down over here where the circuit breaker box goes, right there. So anyway, I am pretty close to having the routing of this finalized, and I can start clamping it in place where it goes. At least in a couple places, at least get this one where it goes. I can lock these down, and then I can work on this area over here and start seeing if I can get this stuff closer to where it needs to be, and then I'll figure that side out. So it's coming together. It's just takes time to figure some of this stuff out, but we're getting it. So let me get a little further along, and then I'll bring you back in. Okay, so got a lot accomplished here. Let me show you what I got. So I got the area up there secured, directed where it needs to go. I've got all of this now where it needs to go. So I've done a lot of work. So we got this all secured. And you can see as we come this way, we got our cluster of wires here for your window controls. And we come back here and we're getting into all of our console back here. And that, the rest of it runs through this plastic piece along here to the back, and then we get our little jog piece right there. And then coming out of that, we go to the windows and over here and the window control, and then comes over here to the window over here. And then we go back this way, and as we climb up, that runs to the back of the car. So that's where I'm at now. So I'm about to go ahead and secure these going up here. I got to splice back in over here to my fuel sending unit and get that done. And then I'm just going to secure the rest of the harness all the way around back by the lights. And I will then have all of the prep work for the car done. And then I can start working on the firewall, dashboard, all those things going in, so that I can get started on that, the engine, because the engine is just about ready for me to, it's ready for me to build. But I don't want to do that yet until I get a little bit farther along on the car. So anyways, got a lot done. The electrical is pretty darn close to where it needs to be. The section over here, when I start to put the new AC unit in, I'll work on the routing of that. But I just, without the AC unit and knowing exactly where everything's going to go, I'd rather just hang that just like it is for now. All right, so let's move to the back of the car. Okay, so let's show you where I'm at. So we've already seen all this, so this is where we kind of pick up from here. So we're all secured. We run up, you can see here, we run all the way up through there. Then we come in here, we come through, I've got it broke off going down to the fuel sending unit. And then we come back here to the lights in the back. And then we come around, and you can see here we've got everything in, secured, all the way down. Then when we come out here, you can see we got our outlet, our lights here, here, and there. This bumper had to come off to do all that, so if you're doing any of this deep, you're not going to be able to get these in place with the bumper on. You're going to have to keep the bumper has to go on after the electrical's run. Or you can take it off like I did, because, you know, I like to do that. Anyways, bumper's back on. Electrical's run. All I gotta do now is put the lenses and everything in here and we're good to go. And as far as back here, the wiring goes, we're pretty well complete, except we gotta wire in the electronic fuel pump. So that'll happen later in the build when I get the engine in, and then I'll get all that wired in. All right, guys, that's all we got. We're gonna go ahead and stop this one here. I have the interior pretty well prepped and ready to go to start putting in the brake pedal, emergency or whatever brake, parking brake, fresh air vent, the AC unit, the dashboard. So all of those things, the courtesy lights that go up in inside of here. I can start getting all that in. The wiring's all there, ready to go. So I can start getting all of that done. And then we can go from there. I mean, I got to get back on the engine and all those kinds of things. So anyway, we're going to cut it here. And then we're going to pick it up from there, starting to build up this firewall. All right. Appreciate you guys watching. And I'll see you guys on the next one.